Hi, my name is Jadeep, and I am a product management intern here at the Compute Networking TME Lab. TME is technical marketing engineering, and we provide data-driven marketing analytics to various departments here at Dell and customers. With the recent rise of AI, it's important for companies to make sure they can streamline their processes utilizing AI. And since this is a very new process, the interns here in the TME space created a comprehensive step-by-step guide to allow companies to choose their server architecture, deploy their LLMs, and maintain these servers in the long run. Let's go into the networking lab to see some of the servers that we worked with in our project. Here we have a R760XA, which supports 4 double-wide H100 GPUs. The R760XA provides a high-performance computing server that allows a flexible, scalable platform for various workloads and use cases. Right next to it, we have the industry-leading XE9680, which supports up to 8 GPUs specifically designed for AI workloads. It specializes in machine learning, inferencing, and deep learning. Now that we're in our workspace, let's look into some of the GPUs that we utilized in our testing and analysis. The top performing GPUs that I noticed were the H100 SXM, H100 PCIe, L40S, and the A100 SXM. What's really interesting is for specific scaling from 1 to 2 to 4 GPUs, it's interesting to see that as the number of concurrent users go up, the average throughput goes down. But as you scale, it linearly goes up similarly. The two most important metrics companies should consider are throughput and the number of concurrent requests that are expected on the server. Now, Amal will deploy the LLM model, and you'll actually see the chat that's being generated by this model.
Hello, my name is Amal Mire. I am a Seattle University student, and I'm a product management intern at Dell. This summer, I'm going to be working on LLM deployment, which are large language models. Deployment on the R760XA server. Originally, my server had L40S GPUs, but I upgraded them to NVIDIA H100 GPUs using data from my colleague Jadeep's research. I'm also going to be working with the models on the Dell Enterprise Hub on Hugging Face. The models that I'm going to be working on include the Meta 8 billion parameter model. I fine-tuned these models and I created a user interface using Gradio. Gradio is a very simple user interface that allows the users to interact with the model. The user can ask questions to the model and get responses directly from the model. The last part of my project is writing a technical white paper. My paper is going to be a comprehensive beginner's guide on large language model deployment, and it is going to include everything from getting your server up and running to deploying these models, and lastly, creating a user interface with Gradio. I'll now hand it over to Kanika, who will tell us a little bit more about keeping your servers up to date once the LLM is deployed.
Hi, my name is Kanika. I'm a third-year computer science student working as a product management intern here at Dell. Many of you either experienced or know somebody that experienced the tech outage that happened in July of 2024. This was caused by a cybersecurity company that rolled out a flawed software update. Now, this is important because here at Dell, I conducted research on the how, when, and why of firmware updates, and how Dell supporting its customer to make sure that our customers don't lose any of their valuable time and money. Over the span of 10 weeks, I talked to product managers, engineering, and IT teams to learn about the Dell PowerEdge XE9680 server that you might have seen in JD's clips. Now, this server is a powerhouse. It's one of the most expensive servers, but also one of the most loved products out there in the market right now. It can run the largest of largest models and data workloads. Dell's number one priority right now is the stability of its platforms that are currently out in the market. One of the ways Dell does that is by providing many different methods of updating its firmware and letting IT admins know well in advance about when to expect the updates. As an intern here on the TME team, by conducting this research, I gathered all the information and published a getting started guide to firmware updates on the Dell AI PowerEdge servers that covers everything from government regulations to 8 different methods of updating with information on time, effort, and frequency to tips and tricks grabbed from all over the Dell Infohub. Check out the amazing Dell Infohub for you to reference when performing your next firmware update.
Now let's recap some of our parts that we talked about in our intern project. Initially, you want to choose your server architecture for your specific AI needs. Then you want to deploy the LLM model of your choice. And then you want to maintain that server in the long run to make sure there aren't any defects. Thank you for checking out and being a part of our intern journey. And if you want to learn more about our project, please check some of the links in the description. Thank you.